Hi there, this is Tafakari Initiative and welcome to our channel. If you're new to us, Tafakari Initiative is a Kenyan NGO that supports the integration of technology into education. We do this through various ways, such as the video that you're watching, and also through trainings that we offer to educators and also to parents, so that they can be able to better understand how to integrate technology into the learning of their charges. We thank you very much for your continued support, even as we continue to put out content for you to enjoy and to make use of, and we hope that it has been useful to you. And even as we continue to do so, we will pay attention to trends that are ongoing globally and also locally to try and find stories that are relevant, developments that are useful to you, and in the end ensure that you are kept one step ahead as far as technology for education is concerned. So today we're going to be reviewing something interesting called Microsoft Family Safety. So this is a tool for online safety that is made by Microsoft, and it involves creating a family group and then putting your family members under those groups. So I'm on the website right now. As you can see, it's a very friendly website. There's some content there basically describing what the app does. With the app, you can be able to set screen time limits. You can be able to block inappropriate content. You can also get activity reports and see your kids' weekly activity reports on all their apps, games, and devices. And you can also be able to find your family, like for example, during an emergency. You can also share apps. You can also share content, have a common browser. And so it's a very useful way to maintain online safety and also maintain the boundaries of online activity within your family space. So we're going to explore it by first creating a family group. And so that's what I'm about to do. So to create a family group, I will need to have a Microsoft address, either Outlook or Live or Hotmail. I just logged into that. As you can see, I'm back on the page. Then I'm going to explore the mobile app. So I'm getting Microsoft Family Safety. I clicked on that link and it will take me to another page, which asks me to put in my email address, which I am doing currently. And the email is duniakoteonline@outlook.com. So once I've typed that in, I'm then going to click on send now. Yes, I've typed it in and I'm clicking on send now. So once that is sent, I'm expecting that when I open my inbox, I will find an email. So I'm on my search engine looking for Outlook. So as I open the mailbox, I expect that I'll be able to find a link from Microsoft, which takes me to where I can download the apps. They make the apps for iOS and Android as well. And you can also use it on PC. So I'm going to download the Android app and let's see how that goes. It's a very interesting app. It's a very intuitive system. It's something that you'll use with ease. So here I am on Google Play. And as you can see, it's the Microsoft Safety app. So it says that Microsoft's Family Safety app helps empower you and your family to create healthy habits and protect the ones you love with digital and physical safety. Get peace of mind that your family is staying a little safer while giving your kids independence to learn and grow. Just basically a description of what the app can do. So there's also some features described. For one, you can be able to get activity reports. You can get a weekly activity log of screen time and online usage, as well as a weekly email summary of activity. You can set screen time so that you can be able to regulate what they do on their devices. You can also filter content and also track your family. Something interesting is that you can also get driving reports. So it's a very interesting app, something that you might really enjoy getting to use. I'm on some new screens here. This has screen captures from the PC end of things, because you can also use the app on PC. So this is about setting up activity. So this will tell me what activities have been carried out over a given time frame. And this tab is for choosing devices and then setting the device limits in terms of screen time, how much access do your family group members have to these devices. So you can both set limits such that someone can go to move to the next activity. But at the same time, you also have game and app limits. This allows you to set limits in terms of the apps that they use, and even game limits, that they do not access games that are beyond their age or that have inappropriate content. Then we also have content restrictions, so that particular browsers will not be allowed to be used on a device. And at the same time, it also allows you to restrict the kind of content that your family group members can access using the browser. So basically, it removes the other apps and leaves the Microsoft Edge. Also, you can be able to find your loved ones. Like for example, if there's some sort of unrest or you have some concerns about their whereabouts, you can be able to do it through that app. So it's a very robust app. It's very versatile, and we hope that you'll get to enjoy it as you use it. It's free, so you can start using it immediately. And the good thing about it is that it can be used on iOS or on Android as well. So from us at Tafakari Initiative, we wish you all the best as you continue to use it. And as always, happy learning.